Practice set 1, problem number 1. List 3 unique ways that this angle can be labeled. Angles can be labeled to help identify them. This is important when the angle is part of a more complex diagram. We'll start by using the 3-letter system, where we use this symbol to represent angle, so we could call this angle RST. We could also call it angle TSR. Both of these are considered equivalent. The important thing is that the vertex, the point where the two sides of the angle come together, must always be in the middle. Another possibility is that we can identify this angle by its size. In this case, that size is indicated by the letter Y, so this would also be a correct way of labeling it. We could use a single letter system. In that case, we would call this angle S, and this would be okay because there's no possibility that the angle can be mistaken for another angle. In the event we had a more complex diagram, say we had a side coming down here with this being Q, then listing angle S would bring some confusion to the diagram, not knowing whether we were talking about this smaller acute size, this smaller acute size, or the two together. So angle S here would be acceptable because of the simplicity of the diagram.